over the years, we've had the opportunity to see all sorts of amazing holiday light shows from the MakerPipe community. They've used EMT conduit from hardware stores and the connectors that we manufacture to make prop frames and all sorts of unique things to incorporate into their holiday light shows. And in today's video, we're going to do a roundup and we're going to showcase these clever uses of materials. And we're going to take a look and see their shows in action, which is always a ton of fun. So these are some of my favorite projects to see from the community. So with that said, let's jump right in and check them out. First up is this show from Elliott. And the way he used conduit and connectors was, as you can see, he built a framework to hold up various props on the outside of the frame. So instead of individually mounting all of these props, he's built a framework that is bolted directly to his house using conduit hanger straps. We can see that he used, it looks like, a lot of the MakerPipe T connectors to basically just add poles wherever he needed to mount the various fixtures to. And we can see here it's pretty simple, not a ton of, you know, pipes and connectors in there, but like I said, just anywhere he needed to mount the different lights, that's where he's added a pole with the T connector, and then he's bolted everything directly to his brick wall on the outside of the house, which is really awesome. And I love his review. He said, "I've been doing big Christmas lights for years. As my show has grown, my need for a solution to mount the bulky and heavy props has also grown. MakerPipe has changed my life. My show brings joys to a lot of people, and MakerPipe has made my life much easier," which is fantastic. We love hearing reviews like that. And I imagine it's really rewarding to put a ton of effort into shows like this and then have people drive and enjoy it and come out and watch it and everything. So that's really awesome. So with that said, let's take a look at this. This is my favorite part. Let's take a look at the show itself. This was for Halloween. And this is fantastic. There you can see above the garage, that's where the framework is that he made with MakerPipe and conduit. And these shows are just so involved. There's so much that goes into it.
He was looking for a soul to steal. He was in a bind because he was way behind and he was willing to make a deal.
You can see he's got like this light panel here, and it actually has this projected, you know, the singer is actually like moving its mouth, and the way the lights are moving, it's like he's actually there singing. Now, which is really cool.
Give the devil his due. I bet a fiddle of gold against your soul because I think I'm better than you. The boy said, "My name's Johnny, and it might be a sin, but I'll take your bet you're going
to
regret."
Oh, gosh, these are always so cool to see. Really awesome. And just look at all the different things happening at once. Got the backup singers and all the different things. And I don't know if he used MakerPipe and conduit in other places, but definitely here above the garage, as we saw in that picture, which is really awesome to see. So thanks so much, Elliott, for sharing that review and for sharing the video of the show in action and the photo of the props. We love seeing it. Next up is this show from Keith, and he built this, I think, for his friend's chiropractic business. And here you can see a photo of the show lit up at night, and we'll look at the video here in a moment. But you can see how they use MakerPipe and conduit. So they attached a framework to the roof, and very similarly to Elliott's build and a lot of the different shows we'll look at, they basically just made a framework exactly where they wanted to mount the props and then mounted the props directly to that framework in different places. And the beauty of doing something like this is we've seen a lot more recently that builders are doing Halloween shows and then just keeping the frame the same and just changing out these light fixtures to something Christmas themed after Halloween is over with, which is a really good idea and makes sense, especially if you can just, you know, undo the connections here for the lights and then, you know, take off whatever mount is holding on the fixtures themselves and then change them out. That's super easy and you can keep the framework in place. And as you can see, there's, you know, various framework all over the roof here in a few different places. There's a large tree in the back here. It looks like they used some conduit and a mixture of some, I'm not sure what is, I forget what that's called right now, but some of that railing as well. And you can also see, I think they said they were using an old prop that they had as kind of an anchor just for added security, which is a good idea, if, you know, if this stuff is bolted to the roof. And you got sandbags securing it in place, which is really cool. And here we'll see it in action. And so they got all the different things. That's where the MakerPipe framework was, up top there. Super cool. Love seeing these shows, man. Never gets old. So really awesome. Thanks so much for sharing this, Keith. Great job with the frame and the show. It's really great to see. Next up is a show from Claudio, and I don't think they showed or shared a video of it in action, but they did share this awesome photo, and you can see this one is really involved. It's got a mega tree. It's got all kinds of stuff mounted to the roof, and that's actually what's made out of maker pipe. So they constructed these frames, and they utilized half-inch EMT conduit to make the frames that hold up the different light fixtures. And they basically just built these stands that sit on the slope of the roof and then have sandbags holding them in place. So that way you don't have to drill anything and secure anything to the roof. It's just kind of all freestanding. And then they're just using the weight of the sandbags to hold the frames in place, which is a good idea. And we can see they made all kinds of various frames. Here it is out in the driveway as they were building it. A pretty standard frame, you know, just using half-inch EMT conduit with the maker pipe T connectors. And then, like we've seen with other builds, just basically adding those pipes wherever you need to secure a light fixture to. And here you can see, I think this is the base of the mega tree. And they have, I think it's made out of EMT conduit. And I'm sure it goes all the way around. It's a big circle for the base of the mega tree. And they've got a maker pipe T connector adding a vertical that goes into the ground and secures that in place, which is really cool. And makes a lot of sense. And we did a video last year on how to make incremental bends if you're making like mega trees or arches for trellises and different things. And I'll link that video in the description because it's really helpful and put a lot of effort into that and making a calculator that makes it easy to figure out how to make large radius bends. So check that out if you're interested. But that's really cool. And then again, we can go back and we can see the show all lit up. And it's just really awesome. Like I said, never gets old. Love seeing all these different shows. Thanks so much for sharing this, Claudio. Really awesome. Next up is a build from Jeffrey Tell, and this is from a few years ago. I think he's done some more recently, but wanted to share this one from a couple years ago. It's a really cool one. And if you've been watching the channel since the very beginning, Dave reacted to this the very first time we ever saw this, and it was really cool to see back then, but I wanted to highlight it again here too. And just like with Elliott, he was saying that this is kind of a game changer because it allowed him to make frames without drilling holes in his house. So you can see here the way that Jeffrey made the frames was kind of sits in the channel here in the driveway and then kind of attaches to the underneath area of the driveway up here, or not the driveway, of the garage door up here. And then basically just like we've seen, it's just a simple T connector going down to basically add a pole wherever you want to mount the fixture to. And he's just got various ones there going all around here in front of the garage. And then he also built a framework here. Instead of mounting these light matrix panels directly to the house, and like he said, drilling holes all in the house, he basically just built a frame that holds up the panel and then has pipes going down to the back of the railing here. And then he's got, looks like some like pebbles or stone there to act as sandbags. Also got some sandbags back there. And it looks like it's strapped to the pillars, which is fine, you know, you're still not drilling holes or anything, which is great, and that's secured in place. And then we can see here is the show in action from the Tell family Christmas lights. You don't know the power of the dark side. I love the drone view. So cool. They've got the mega trees. You don't know the power of the dark side. You don't know the power. There's so much effort into the show itself and then also into the production of these videos, which is cool. And that makes it great for us who are watching it, you know, online. That's really awesome. And then you can see the various, there's the frames around the garage they made with conduit and maker pipe. And then the ones up there in front of the porch as well. Super cool. And I know conduit and maker pipe is such a small part of these shows, but it's still really cool to see them incorporated and hear that they solve problems for people. So really cool. Thanks so much, Jeffrey, for sharing that. Love seeing it. Next up is another show from a Keith. And this is really elaborate and really complex. So not only are there frames to hold up various props, but there's actually a fake second story false roof to add pretty much a whole like second level to the light show. As you can see here, this is such an elaborate build. Basically, there's a wooden framework that's attached to the roof, and then they built this frame out of EMT conduit and maker pipe connectors, and it's basically just meant to give the look and feel of a second story eave and roof. And it's just super fantastic, and there's so many things incorporated into it, so many connections. And here we can see how he's got attached to the roof itself, or the fake roof, he's got just poles going up with T connectors and then mounts to hold on the light fixtures. And it's just, like I said, super elaborate, but so cool and just really awesome to see. And once we go back and look at this final photo, you can see added some black plastic up there. So at night, you know, just like with all of these frames, you can see them in the daylight. But when it's night, look, it looks like a second story house or a two-story house, and looks like the second story there. And you would be none the wiser if you were just looking at this without knowing that it was the framework that he built with conduit and maker pipe. So really cool and a really elaborate build, but really awesome. And I think he shared a video
Welcome
as well.
Welcome to the Kisinger Family Light Show. Merry Christmas.
Oh, that's great. Love hearing from the kids to announce it.
Welcome to the show.
So cool. And like I said, you wouldn't have no idea if you were just looking at this on the street and you just pulled up to watch, have no idea that that wasn't a real second story. So really cool. And a lot of awesome things incorporated into this. Thanks so much, Keith, for sharing that. Really love to see it. Next up is another really interesting one. This one was shared by Nicholas a couple of years ago, and this was a light show built around a McDonald's drive-thru, which is really wild and something, if you would have asked me, if I would have expected, it would definitely would be a no. But as you can see, it's a McDonald's drive-thru, and they basically built a tunnel that goes from the grass next to the McDonald's all the way up and over to the roof, and then they secured lights to the framework. So when you're waiting in line for your Big Mac or your McChicken, you can enjoy the holiday lights and the Christmas lights. Super cool. And like I said, super unexpected, but awesome nonetheless, and really cool to see. So thanks so much, Nicholas, for sharing this. Really awesome, and all kinds of cool stuff in there. Next up is this one. This one was shared recently, and this one comes from Jim. And he is doing something similar where he's got a Halloween display up, and then he's changing it over to Christmas lights. And just like I said, he built the framework here in the yard, and he just made it so he could mount various props for different times of year. And right now he's got a spider web up. Well, maybe not now that Halloween's over with, but whenever he shared this photo, it had a spider mounted to it. And of course, you can see the framework during the day, but at night it disappears, as you can see here in this photo, and then as we'll see in the show. And again, he just used maker pipe T connectors. That's a really common connector across all of these builds. Seems like that's what builders are finding the most useful. And that's what we see commonly with other projects as well. The T connector is usually used for a lot of things. But just a simple frame, kind of an A frame here, and just angled to hold up the prop. And then, of course, the light itself, the whole fixture is mounted to it. And then here we'll check out the video. And I love this one. This show has some cool things incorporated into it. That's a bit loud. Let's see here. This is going to be in your head for ever since I first saw this video a few days ago. This song has been in my head, so I'm sure it's going to happen to you too.
I was looking in the lab late one night when my eyes beheld an eerie sight. For my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mash.
I love this. It's got the pumpkins in the front. And there's something, I guess it's a projector, projecting faces onto the pumpkins, and they're singing the song. It's kind of like what we saw with Elliott's build, where the light matrix, you know, the different pixels were moving to move the mouth. But this, is a projector, if I'm not mistaken.
He did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
He did the mash.
He did the monster mash from my laboratory in the castle east. to the master bedroom.
So cool. And like I said, it's always cool to see, you know, Maker Pipe and Conduit are playing a, such a small part, and these are such elaborate things. But as Elliott said, you know, they're putting a lot of effort into these shows, but I'm sure it's really rewarding to have people get a lot of joy out of them. So really cool. Thanks, everybody, for sharing these light shows with us. Always love seeing them, and it's such a blast. And if you want to check any of these out in more detail, they'll be linked down below. Thanks, everybody, for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.